Hello, and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am available for contracting, code reviews, and on-site training. In this episode, I'm going to do a little bit of a kind of back-to-the-basics kind of thing with dealing with standard set and standard map and comparators. So these are the associative containers in C++. And if you've ever gone to use one with a custom type, you might have ended up with something like this. And you think, I want a set of all of the unique data-y things that I have. So you're like, this is awesome, I have my set of my data, and everything compiles, and you're happy. And then you go to add something to it. And you're like, well, let's just insert, say, my data of like this. And you get many, many, many lines of compiler errors. And the first time you encounter this, you're like, what in the world is going on? So you probably Google or use Stack Overflow or something. And you notice this consistency that there's this operator less than problem. So what you realize you need is you need an operator less than so that the set has a way of comparing to know whether or not this piece of data has already existed in the set. So you probably then go back and do something like this. And you provide your own operator less than, and we expect this to compile. And it does, and we're happy again. But then you go and you add some, I don't know, other value to this. And now you're stuck with this, like how like exacting do I want to make my operator less than? And you really didn't care. Like really, for your purposes, one of these is a key. And you're saying, I need the key to be the thing that is determining whether or not this is a unique thing. So now you're in this world where less than operator doesn't really make any sense. You need something that is sortable so that set can do the comparisons it needs to. But you know that you've got one piece of unique thing here and the operator less than that you've provided isn't really giving a true less than comparison. So let's go ahead and see like how we can fix this. So if you have never really looked at what set is a template and the standard library, and the first template argument is the key, and that's what we've been dealing with this whole time. But the second template argument is a comparator. And by default, it is std less of key. So how can we provide our own comparator? And it's not that hard to do. You simply need something that has got a operator paren call operator to it. So we're like, let's create our new struct that is our comparator. And we need to have our member function that can do the comparison that we want it to do. And now we can provide to our set template this compare type that we just created. So now we've provided a custom comparator for it. And we can go back in and we can remove this operator less than because it was incomplete and it wasn't really what we needed for this particular purpose. So we've got our operator paren that we've provided as a member function here to our struct compare, and then we pass in this type compare. And we get a default construction of this compare object in our set here when we have constructed our set object. So this was a basic introduction to providing your own comparator to the associative containers in the standard library. In this example, set, but this also applies to multi-set, map, and multi-map. So next week, we'll dig in a little bit more into some of the things that we can do with our comparators. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.